What's up, everyone? How you doing? Happy Monday. We are coming to you live from Home Depot. All right, so it's not my morning ride because this morning I had a mission that I had to handle before I was able to get up and do my ride. And that is to find the smell at my friend's restaurant, Mandarino. So those of you in the area know that you've been in there recently, and it's got a funky smell, and you're not really sure what it is, and you haven't been going back. And my buddy Antonio basically reached out and said, I don't know what to do. I've called plumbers. No one can figure out what's wrong. No one's showing up. So we decided to do some exploratory work. And Friday, we jumped down into the crawl space and found some water leaking, but it was in a back area that we couldn't get to. So this morning we got in there at 6 a.m. We cut a hole in the floor. We climbed down in there and we found a pipe fitting that came apart that went to a back sink. And that back sink is where they dump a lot of the juice from the fresh mozzarella and stuff like that. So you got all that stuff leaking into the basement and kind of just rotting. And we opened the floor up and we found a pipe disconnected. Super, super, super simple solution. And we are fixing the problem. We have a company coming in to dry out the basement and do a little cleanup down there, sanitize everything and get it all fresh down there. And you will be able to go back to hang out at Pomodorino because we love hanging out there and no one wants to hang out if it smells. So the moral of this story is that everyone was making this basically a mountain out of a molehill. Everyone's like, oh, it's a sewer issue, the sewer's backed up, yada, 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 all this nonsense. Everyone was just saying that it was such a big deal, and that's what the smell was, when it was as simple as a 2-inch pipe front coat fitting that loosened up and came apart from basically a wash sink in the back. So everyone was afraid to dive in. Everyone was making excuses. Everyone was afraid to dive in and do the work. And everyone was afraid to chop a hole in the floor and get down and figure out what's going on. Everyone was avoiding it because everyone thought it was bigger than it really was. So in our lives, this is something that happens a lot. We have these ideas in our head that a situation is bigger than it really is, that the solution is much harder than it really is. And we need to realize this, that we need to just tackle stuff in our lives. We need to just grab the bull by the horns and just dive in. Here's an issue that's been going on for probably a couple months now. It's been getting gradually worse. I think as the fitting started leaking and leaking and leaking, and finally it got to the point where it fell off. And lately that fitting fell off and the sink water has been draining into the basement and making a funky smell. So it's something that really was really simple. It's a freaking $10 part. The hardest part is obviously we had to chop a hole in the floor, in the back, through the tile, cut the plywood out, the wonder board, and basically get down there and get to it because it was in an area that was inaccessible from the main part of the crawl space. So we come up with new solutions, right? We think outside the box. We figured out where it is. We roughly measured across, then we popped the hole in the floor. We got lucky. Where we popped the hole in the floor happened to be right over the bed connection. And we put the connection back together, we turned all the water back on, and everything is dry as could be. So this thing that's been going on now for a month, and all these plumbers have been coming in and saying that, you know, it's a sewer issue and it's this big major problem, turned out to be a $10 loose fitting. So just think about it in your life. Things that you think are big, things that you think are a major problem that's going to take a big major solution, probably aren't that big. It's probably simple. You just grab the bull by the horns and you just jump in and fix that problem. Dive in head first and go for it. Commit to it and fix the problem. You know, stop avoiding stuff in your life. This situation was getting avoided because no one wanted to dive in. No one wanted to chop a hole in the floor and do the discovery that needed to happen. And there's a little lesson for you there. So you need to commit to things. You need to dive in. Stop avoiding things in your life. Dive in, fix the problem. Stop dealing with a problem instead of diving in and fixing it. Stop making excuses of and making something bigger than it really is. So anyway, there's your message of the day. Hope that made sense to you. We're gonna say prayers in a Home Depot parking lot. This is something new. This is something new. But don't worry, we're gonna ride today. It's gotta be later on. We had to get in here early so that we can get to figure out what the problem is and get it fixed. So, all right, let's we got a nice sunrise over here. In the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Dear God, help us to realize that things in our life aren't as big as we make them out to be. At times, help us to realize this and help us to dive in and handle our problems and handle the situations in our life and to do the work that's required to make things better. Help us to be grateful for everything in our lives and help us to enjoy this holiday season. Amen. All right, so we're at Home Depot now. I got to go get some repairs to fix the floor. That's what we're here for. The pipe is fixed. Pomodorino. We'll be safe to go back and eat and drink. And I mean, it was always safe, but just smell a little bit. But the smell that you're smelling in there will be fixed, is fixed. The pipe is connected. The cleanup will happen downstairs in the crawl space. Get all that musty water out of there. And we'll be good to go again. So that's a good thing because I know a lot of us like to hang out over there and people have been avoiding it. So, we found the problem, and we fixed the problem, and we are going to get everything all back together. They are open Wednesday again for running into the holiday festivities. They got catering stuff going on and whatnot, and that's it. So we are back in action. Don't make mountains out of molehills. Take your problems head on. Fix the problems. Stop making excuses. Stop making things bigger than they really are. Do the work. Commit to it and get stuff done in your life. Stop putting stuff off. Stop making a big deal out of things that aren't a big deal. All right, everyone, put your head on a pillow every night knowing you made the world a better place. Fire starts fire. Don't worry, I'll ride later. I'll post the Strava up so you know I'm not cheating. Day 223 today. It is really freaking cold this morning, 26 degrees. But once we get Pomodorino put back together, we'll jump out and get our ride in, and I'll share it for you guys. All right, appreciate you all. Have a great week. Monday, fun day. Let's go. Let's make something happen this week. God bless.